An Englishman and a Frenchman were drilling a tunnel under the channel. Who made sure they met in the middle?
They all really dressed.
The Frenchman is called Philippe Creuset and the Englishman is called Graham Fagg. And they did meet in the middle. I mean, they were like just like 300-odd millimetres out. I mean, it was extraordinary how accurate it was. But what would they use to know exactly
sonar,
where they were?
Sonar, I would imagine.
Shouting?
Not sonar. Not shouting. No. Just...
We are healed! God, we've gone past you!
That's the way.
Coming back.
So then they would just say, no, 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 it's two tunnels. One is
the we'll keep going, we'll keep going. Yeah. Have you read Birdsong by Sebastian Bach?
Indeed, yes.
It's all about tunnelling.
The saps. Yeah.
It's a brilliant book.
It is
but they would tunnel underneath the enemy trenches, plant explosives, and then. But of course, the other side were doing the same thing. So they would be. It's a brilliant novel. Yeah. They're in the tunnel, and everyone has to be completely quiet, and they can hear the Germans. Tunneling.
Yeah.
And they are they going to let their bomb off? Are we going to let our bomb off? I can't see how quiet it's gone. That's how good the book is.
Yeah.
Right. I'm going to tell you what happens.
Yeah.
But it's really good.
It is.
Be a Scot, be an engineer.
It wasn't a Scot, I'm
come
afraid.
Come on.
You'd think it would be.
Oh, well, is that Superman up the top there?
It is Superman.
Well spotted. They were told to wear high visibility clothing, and he did.
Yeah. Well, no, he came straight from a party the night before.
I think he did. Obviously, it was some celebration there.
That machine that they used, they had it at the side of the motorway for ages after they'd finished the tunnel. It had a large sign on the side of it, just said, "One careful owner."
The French rather sweetly gave them names: Brigitte, Europa, Catherine, Virginie, Pascaline, and Séverine. And they, after the tunnel, they dismantled them and rebuilt them and, you know, kept them. And the British didn't give them names, rather dully. And they made the machines burrow themselves into the ground where they just left them.
Oh, oh. That says it all, doesn't it?
Oh.
I'm ashamed. Oh. I'm faintly ashamed.
So who did get them to meet in the middle?
A German invented a machine to do it. And the machine is called a gyrotheodolite, because the problem is you can't know where you are underground because you can't use a compass because of the magnetic ore in...
Or GPS.
Or GPS, because you haven't got line of sight, obviously, with the...
Turn left.
Yeah. So it uses, being a gyrotheodolite...
Do a U-turn when possible.
When possible.
Yes.
Please do a U-turn.
You are under the sea.
Yeah. But no, it was, what would a gyrotheodolite use to find out where you are or where north is? So gyro means?
Revolving.
Revolving. It's the rotation of the earth.
Ah.
Feels that. So it can work out where north is.
Oh, why don't you just ask Superman?
Yeah, you just ask Superman. Who has a little place in the North
Superman's
Pole.
Superman's got a hard hat. Come on, you're the man of steel. Not too careful.
Yeah. So it was a German invention. His name is Max Schuller.
So they had one at each... The French had one of these machines and the British had one of these machines.
They didn't meet halfway, however. Who had got furthest, the French or the English?
Oh, the English, surely.
No, French. We got further.
It was the French, because the English were wandering about disposing of the earth out the bottom of their trousers. Making sure nobody could see. Just past the guy vaulting the horse, we'll be fine, come on.
We got further.
Yes, but not because the French were lazy and work shy.
Well, they were talking to their machines, weren't they? My beautiful machine.
They had geological difficulties therein.
Oh, we are experiencing geological difficulties at the moment, mon petit cher, but soon it will all be good. No, they're giving the names.
Let's see English, does it work?
Yeah. Remind me, Stephen, of the German who made, what was it, a gyroscopic theodolite?
Yes.
Because I've got to say, a brilliant invention, but not a huge market.
No, you're right. That's unfortunately true. There's just not enough tunnels being built there.
They had sword too.
Yeah.
It's all going very well. Yeah. We were hoping for sales of one, but they're selling two.
There was a man called Colonel Barog. He could have used it in India when they were doing a tunnel for the railway there, and... They missed, and he went home and shot himself. He was so ashamed.
Did he hit?
Yeah.